CPR is crucial in the instance of someone going into cardiac arrest. It buys you time against brain damage, which is vital for survival. Today we're going to demonstrate the most current method of CPR, which according to the Seattle Fire Department has the highest success rates.
Chris Hanza, a fire medical specialist from the Hawai'i Fire Department, instructed some students on how to do hands-only CPR.
We're going to lock our fingers together, leaning directly over our victim. And how far down do I need to push? At least 2 inches, okay, at a rate or a speed of 100 to 120 compressions a minute. So it should be roughly about this speed here. Notice how I'm locking my elbows and bending at my waist. I'm pushing down on 2 inches. Once somebody stops breathing, within 4 to 6 minutes, brain damage is occurring. And that will never regenerate and you'll never get that back. CPR should be done if somebody's not breathing, not responding. We should start immediate CPR. But don't forget to always call 911 and activate the emergency response system. And it's good if somebody, if there's an AED in the area, somebody can run and go get the AED and put that AED or automated external defibrillator on as soon as possible.
In order to perform successful CPR, you must push down at least 2 inches into the victim's chest at a steady speed of 100 to 120 compressions a minute and make sure to call 911 and instruct someone to get an AED.
Just remember, in an emergency, it is important that you don't stall. Call 911.